friends, in this session we will be looking at the various representations of binary numbers that are used in computer arithmetic. Now, let's see what all things we are going to see. First of all, as far as binary numbers are concerned, the very first thing is that the numbers can be either unsigned or the numbers can be signed. Okay, so we can either have unsigned representation or we can have signed representation. Now, what is the meaning of unsigned representation? In unsigned representation, non-negative numbers can be represented. So whatever numbers we are trying to represent, all the numbers will be greater than or equal to 0. And greater than or equal to 0 means negative numbers cannot be represented. Okay. So negative numbers cannot be represented in unsigned representation. Okay. And as far as signed representation is concerned, so all the drawbacks can be overcome. So in signed representation, all numbers can be represented. So integers, every integers, all integers, I would say, both positive as well as negative can be represented. And that means the numbers can be positive, negative or zero. So positive numbers are possible. Okay, negative numbers are also possible and zero can also be represented. So that is the fundamental difference between unsigned and signed representation. So whenever you need to represent positive as well as negative integers, we will be going for signed representation. But when negative quantities are not needed, in that case we may also go for unsigned representation. There are certain things in the world which cannot be negative. For example, age of a person cannot be negative, date of birth of a person cannot be negative, the year in which you were born cannot be negative, the price of any particular article cannot be negative, and let us say quantities cannot be negative, the number of students sitting in a class cannot be negative. And that is why in all such cases where negative numbers are not needed, you may prefer unsigned representation over signed representation. And there are lot many other things in which signed representation may be preferred. For example, the temperature in certain condition may be negative, or let us say the growth from 2004 to 2005 may be negative. Negative growths are possible. And there are many other things which can be negative. Okay, product of two integers can be negative. A minus B can be negative. So whenever negative numbers are possible, we will be going for signed representation. Now, as far as unsigned representation is concerned, there is nothing typical about it. Okay, simply you need to convert decimal numbers into binary representation. That will be called as unsigned representation. But as far as the signed representation is concerned, we have got three ways to represent signed numbers. And what are those three ways called as? They are called as, number one, we can either go for sign and magnitude representation, or we may use 1's complement representation, or third, we may use 2's complement representation. Okay, now out of these three representations, it is the third one, 2's complement representation, which is preferred in computers usually. And we will also see the reason why the numbers are, negative numbers are usually represented with the help of 2's complement in computers. Okay, we will see what are the differences between these three representations. We will compare all of them, and finally we will be convinced that why 2's complement is preferred over sign and magnitude as well as 1's complement representation. Okay, and after we are done with this, we will see a more general concept which is called as R's complement and R minus 1's complement, which is also called as the radix complement and diminished radix complement. Diminished radix complement. Okay. So you need not be worried about these two things right now. After we are done with 1's complement and 2's complement, we will naturally go to the concept of R's complement and R minus. Okay. Radix complement is also called as R's complement. And diminished radix complement is also called as R minus 1's complement. So, let us start with the actual conversion, how any particular quantity can be represented in unsigned representation, sign and magnitude, 1's complement and 2's complement. So, we have got four different representations for binary numbers. And one thing, in this session, we will not discuss how to convert decimal numbers into binary numbers. So if you don't know how to convert into binary, you should watch the previous videos on number system, in which we have clearly discussed how to convert decimal numbers into binary numbers. Okay. So these are all the things that we are going to study. And now let us begin with a practical example, with an actual example. So basically what we are going to do, we will take one number, say 15 or let us say 10, and we will try to represent this number in the four different formats. And the formats that we will be seeing is unsigned, then sign and magnitude, after that 1's complement, and after that 2's complement. Okay. Now 10 in unsigned can be represented as 1, 0, 1, 0. The place values here will be 1, 2, 4, 8. So 8 multiplied by 1 plus 2 multiplied by 1 will be equal to 10. Now in sign and magnitude, the number 10 can be represented as, see, what happens in sign and magnitude, we will first write down the magnitude, which is 1, 0, 1, 0. Magnitude is called as the actual value of the number without sign. And the sign here is equal to plus. So plus signs are represented with the help of 0. So plus means 0 and minus means 1. So it is 10, and therefore 10 will be represented as 1, 0, 1, 0, not 1, 0, 1, 0. It will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Because the meaning of 1, 0, 1, 0 will be something different. It will not be equal to 10. It will be equal to minus 2. Okay. In sign and magnitude, if you write down 1, 0, 1, 0, the meaning will be equal to minus 2. We don't want to write down minus 2. We want 10. Therefore, first of all, you should write down 10 as a quantity, and then you should write down the sign, which is plus, and plus signs are indicated with the help of 0. Okay. And now, for converting this 10 in 1's complement, what is the rule for 1's complement? You will invert the individual bits. Okay. You will complement every bit of the number, and the resultant representation will be called as 1's complement. But remember very well, while converting into 1's complement, don't take the 1's complement of 1, 0, 1, 0. Instead, you take the 1's complement of 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay. Now this point is little bit critical. We need to spend certain time here. Lot many students I have seen who make mistake while representing the number in 1's complement. Because what you have in your mind, that simply by inverting every bit, you will get the 1's complement representation. And if you do that, then 1, 0, 1, 0, if you complement, it will become 0, 1, 0, 1, which is wrong representation. Okay. And let me tell you why it's a wrong representation. Because in 1's complement as well as 2's complement as well as sign and magnitude, all the representations which are used for signed numbers, the leftmost bit, the most significant bit, is always the sign bit. Okay. And therefore, if you complement 1010, the complement will be 0101. However, the meaning of 0101 will be plus 5 in 1's complement. But you don't want to write down plus 5. You want to write down plus 10, and that is why you will be representing 10 as 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. No complementation is needed because it's a positive number, and positive numbers are directly represented as in the binary format. Okay, so 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 will be the correct representation. Now one question might come to your mind, why the representation will not be like this, 1, 0, 1, 0. Again, the reason is same. If you write down 1010 in 1's complement, then the last bit will be treated as a sign bit, which is 1. Therefore, it will become a negative number, and we know that 10 is not a negative number, it's a positive number. Therefore, we need to add an extra 0 so that it is treated as a positive number. Okay. And finally, in 2's complement also, 10 will be represented as 0101. Now you should note one thing very important, that all positive numbers will look same in sign and magnitude, 1's complement as well as 2's complement representation. They are not going to change. And in unsigned representation, the leftmost 0 will be ignored, because when you write down 1010, it means 10 and it means plus 10. There is no question of minus 10 because we are dealing with unsigned. In unsigned, there is no place for sign. All the quantities will be considered as positive. Fine. So this is one example. Now let us see. Okay, I will add one more column for decimal. Okay, so this was about 10. Now, minus 10. Let's try to represent minus 10 in different quantities. So, see, minus 10 is a negative number, and negative numbers cannot be represented in unsigned representation. That's why minus 10 in unsigned representation cannot be represented. That is one thing. Now, minus 10 can be represented in sign and magnitude, but in sign and magnitude, how the conversion will be done? It is quite simple. See, here the magnitude is equal to 10 and the sign is negative. So, both the things will be given separate treatment. Every negative number will be having two components, sign and magnitude. Magnitude you convert directly, so 10 in binary will become 1010, and the negative sign will be represented with the help of 1. So here you should divide this number into two parts. This 1010 will be called as magnitude and this 1 will be called as sign. Here also it was the same, magnitude and sign, but because it was plus 10 here, plus will be represented by 0 and the magnitude will be 10 1010. Here it's minus 10, so minus sign will be represented by 1 and the magnitude will remain the same. So you can see in plus 10 and minus 10 the magnitude part is same, only sign part is going to differ, and this is how the negative numbers can be represented in sign and magnitude representation. Now in 1's complement representation, what you need to do, first of all you have done plus 10, so plus 10 will be written as 1010. Okay, now because you want to represent in sign and in sign representation, you add an extra bit 0 and then you do the 1's complement. So how the 1's complement can be done, you invert every bit here, it will 0 will become 1, 1 will become 0, 1, 0, 1, and therefore in 1's complement minus 10 will be looking as 1010, 1. And finally, if you add 1 to the 1's complement, then the resultant representation will be called as 2's complement. So 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 0 will be 1, this will be 1 plus 0, 1, 0 and 1. So 10110 will be the representation of minus 10 in 2's complement. Fine. So after seeing this, there may be certain questions which come to your mind. So let me write down this minus 10 thing first. It was 1010. We added an extra sign bit, extra bit for sign, then we will do for 1's complement. So after inversion, it will be called as 1's complement. This will become 10101, and then plus 1, we will get what is called as 2's complement. So 10 plus 1 will be 01 plus 1 will be 2, and this will be 101. Fine. This is how minus 10 can be converted into all the three representations. Minus 10 is not possible in unsigned representation. Now, certain questions that might come to your mind. Number 1, why didn't we directly invert 1010? While taking 1's complement, why do we add this extra 0? The reason is, if you take 1010 and do 1's complement, the result will be 0101. Now, if you write here 0101, then it means that in this representation, the last bit will always be treated as sign bit. And because the sign bit is equal to 0, this number will be treated as a positive number and the magnitude will become 101, which is 5. And therefore, the meaning of this number will come out to be equal to plus 5, which becomes wrong. We want minus 10. So remember, whenever you want to represent negative numbers in any of the three signed representation, the leftmost bit must always be equal to 1. Because 1 means negative number and 0 means positive numbers. And that is why in order to have that sign bit, we add an extra 0. Then we do the 1's complement, and 1's complement plus 1 will be equal to 2's complement. And that's why this particular representation goes like this. Okay. So let us see some more examples. Let's try to convert minus 25 in all the representations. So minus 25, it's a negative number, therefore it cannot be represented in unsigned representation. Let's try to represent 25 minus in sign and magnitude. Now 25 in binary will be looking like, okay, so we will discuss quickly how 25 can be converted to binary. You keep dividing successively by 2, so 2 multiplied by 12 will be 24, remainder will be equal to 1. 2 multiplied by 6, 12, remainder equal to 0. 2 multiplied by 3, 6, remainder 0. 2 multiplied by 1 is 2 and the remainder is equal to 1. Collect the digits in this fashion and the representation will be 1101. So 25 will be looking like 1100. Okay, and because the sign is negative, you will add an extra bit for negative, and the representation will be looking like 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. But remember very well, this representation is divided into two parts. First part will be called as sign, and second part will be called as magnitude. Here, 1 means minus, and the magnitude means 25, and this is how minus 25 can be written in sign and magnitude representation. Fine. Now, you should note down one thing, that minus 10 could be represented with the help of 4 plus 1, 5 bits, because 10 as a magnitude needs 4 bits. So 4 bits for the magnitude and 1 bit for sign, total 5 bits will be needed. Now in minus 25, 25 itself takes 5 bits to be represented in binary. So 25 will take 5 bits and 1 additional bit for sign, 5 plus 1, total 6 bits will be represented, will be needed for writing down minus 25. Okay. Now remember very well, if you want to write down 25, then only 5 bits will be needed in the unsigned. So 25 will be written as 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. If you want to write down 25 in sign and magnitude, first of all you will write down the magnitude, which is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, and then you will take the sign, which comes out to be equal to 0. If you want to write down 25 in 1's complement, then sign and magnitude will be copied as it is, because in 1's complement, the magnitude will be 25, which is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. You will add an extra bit for sign, and because it's a positive number, you should not go for complement. And also, in 2's complement, it will be represented as 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. So what I would say, that every number, whether positive or negative, will need equal number of bits in all the three representations. And number 2, negative, positive numbers will look alike in sign and magnitude, 1's complement and 2's complement. There is no change. 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, all means plus 25. However, when you write down negative numbers, then they will look different in sign and magnitude, 1's complement as well as 2's complement. So what we are going to do now, in order to write down minus 25 in sign and in 1's complement, first we will write down 25. So 25 is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. But don't go for complementing directly. Before complement, you add an extra bit for sign, and now you take the 1's complement. So if you go for inversion, okay, complementing I will represent with the help of tilde sign. It will be 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So this is 1's complement representation. And okay, I will write down 1's complement as 1c. And if you do plus 1, then the result will be equal to 2's complement. Okay. So 1, 0 plus 1 will be 1, 1, and then 1, 0, 0, 1. So therefore, minus 25 in 1's complement will be this 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and minus 25 in 2's complement will be 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So the rule is 2's complement is equal to 1's complement plus 1. Okay. 2's complement is equal to 1's complement plus 1. That is the fundamental rule that we need to follow for 2's complement representation. And note down very well, in sign and magnitude, the last bit is 0, it means it's a positive number. In 1's complement, the last bit is 0, it means it's a positive number. In 2's complement also, the last bit is 0, which means it's a positive number. In minus 25, in all the representations, the leftmost bits are 1, which means all of them are negative numbers. Okay, so this is how any particular number can be represented in all three representations. And one more thing, positive numbers can be represented in all four representations. Negative numbers can be represented only in three representations, and they are called as signed representations. The first column is called as unsigned representation. Negative numbers cannot be represented in unsigned representations. Okay, so these are the basic examples. We will see more examples in the next video.